If there was one bright spot of the height of the COVID-19 pandemic, and I don't even like calling it a bright spot. That was such a horrible thing that, by the way, is not over. But it was that workers in certain industries, certain areas, were allowed to work from home. Working from home allowed millions of American workers to have a greater work-life balance. And during that time, worker productivity actually skyrocketed. So not only were people working from home, where they were able to get more done around the house, spend more time with their family, they were doing more for work than they were when they were going into the office. But across the country over the last 2 years, everybody's been forced to go back in, get back in that office so we can keep an eye on you 24/7. And a new study has come out showing that workers who are now forced to go back into work every day, which is pretty much everybody at this point, spend an average of $51 per day that they otherwise would not spend if they were working from home. $51 per day. $255 per week, over $1,000 per month. And that money is spent on an average of $16 for lunch, $14 on commuting, $13 on breakfast and coffee, and $8 on parking. Again, this is an average. I don't pay for parking. I don't eat, breakfast. I don't buy expensive coffees. But gas, lunches, things like that, it adds up every day for workers. Workers with pets spend an average of $20 more per day going to the office than the average person. So the average for people with pets is $71 per day. So we, the workers, are losing over $1,000 per month so that middle managers, the people walking around making sure like, hey, did you get that report I sent you? So that those people can feel better about having a job where they don't actually have to do anything. We're spending an extra $1,000 per month to go sit in an office so that our corporate bosses can look over our shoulders and make sure we're not throwing on a load of laundry in between spreadsheets here. That's what this is about. Again, worker productivity when working from home increases by 13%. That is a fact. Productivity throughout the pandemic when people were working from home was even higher than 13%. And I can tell you just, anecdotally, when I work from home versus when I go into the office, I get way more work done. I get it done faster. I get it done better. And I'm also able to get things done around the house. But across the country, workers are forced to go back into these offices. One, to feed the real estate business, right? I mean, hell, in our office that we work in, we actually had two businesses leave that office. Once people started working from home, those businesses realized, like, wait a minute, we don't need to spend $5,000 a month just on renting office space. We can save tons of money if everybody just works from home. We're an accounting firm. Like, let's just do that. And they did it. And they have saved tons of money. So real estate investors need people in those buildings. So people are forced to go back to work. Again, the middle managers, the people who really don't do much, they need to feel like they're being productive. The older folks, right? They like to walk around with a cup of coffee in their hand and chit-chat with everybody. They need to feel like they've got that human connection. And honestly, I get that part. I like to walk around and chit-chat. And I do know that there are some jobs, obviously, where you have to go into an office. But forcing people who are, the stereotypical, as you would call, paper pushers, I guess, those people do not need to physically be in an office to be productive. They don't need to physically be in an office to be a part of the team. They can get more done, be more productive working from home, and they can have a greater work-life balance. That is what we learned during the pandemic. That is what these new studies have confirmed. And people are wasting their money having to drive just so they can sit in a building for 8 hours so that a couple of people on the, ladder above them feel more important. That's what's happening here. We need an overhaul of work here in the United States. If you can work from home, you should be allowed to work from home. That's how this should work. But because the corporate masters want to look over your shoulder and make sure you're spending those 8 hours a day doing stuff, that's why everybody was forced back. And it's also one of the reasons, like I said, why we are still dealing with COVID to this day. Ring of Fire has fresh content 7 days a week, so if you want to be reminded about it, don't forget to subscribe to the channel, hit the little bell to be notified every time a new video goes up.